నూట 80 లక్షల నుండి 1 కోటి మంది వరకు వ్యూయర్స్ ఉన్న సుమన్ టీవీ నెట్వర్క్తో కలిసి మీరు నడవాలనుకుంటున్నారా? అయితే స్క్రీన్ పైన కనిపిస్తున్న ఈమెయిల్ ఐడి అలాగే ఫోన్ నెంబర్కి కాంటాక్ట్ చేయండి.
సో వెన్ విల్ స్టార్ట్ గెటింగ్ డేటా ఫ్రమ్ రోవర్? యాక్చువల్లీ
ఫ్రమ్ రోవర్ దట్ యాస్ సూన్ యాస్ ఇట్ ఇస్ అరౌండ్ 5 ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ వెన్ ద రోవర్ స్టార్ట్ రోల్డ్ అవుట్ ఫ్రమ్ దట్ ల్యాండర్ from that time onward this camera will be acting, this one or the external camera. The scientific data will start coming from that 5.8 hours onwards.
Anybody from this side, please? Yeah,
could you just describe what exactly happens on September 2? You said it will separate. Could you just tell us what is going to happen? What are you going to, what is the team going to, you know, work on this?
See, that is it is here now. The whole thing is going as a single body.
Yeah,
this portion is the orbiter and this is a lander. Now right now the Chandrayaan 2 is the whole thing we are calling Chandrayaan 2, that we are calling composite body. In September 2 what happened is the place where this is the lander is sitting on the orbiter, this point, from this point this thing will be separate out.
Okay, you can take it.
So it will be become like this. Okay. Now it will September, now it will be there go together, and September 2 this people become like this, this one. Now after the September 2nd onward, that is, it's not that we are forgetting this one. Yes, I was just joking, but this orbiter will be on their own in the 100 km orbit. Now we have to control two bodies. One is orbiter. Orbiter also we cannot leave it. We have to control that orbiter, and then our operations will be in the that lander. And in third what happened is it will be second it will go like this. Okay, in third we will be rotating like this, and they have the burn, that is like engines are there, 1, 2, 3, 4 engine and central engine. With that we have a small burn, then we'll bring back the rotating the satellite like this, and fourth once again we'll rotate and burn for this one. By burning this one by fourth the orbit of this one become from 100 by 100 to 100 by 35. One side it has become a less altitude, so that from the less altitude our coming down will be easy. What is the purpose? And the only thing is our friends have put our rover is bigger than lander here. But it is actually guy sitting inside the lander. Only thing is you can see, that's what he has kept away from that this one.
Sir, you know, one of the most significant things in this mission is that it's the first planetary mission, where exploration mission, where we are seeing two women scientists at the helm. When do we get to meet these women? Because you know, so as of now all communication with them with the media has been cut off, seems to have been cut off.
No, this is what happened is, I will say that we have come here, they are working still, they are this one, and in fact they are almost spending 17-18 hours per day work their imams they are doing. They are doing excellent job, this both project director and this one, and once that the landing is over, their job will be, their mind will be free, and you will be allowed to interact with them. And till they are, you are telling, even till you are telling no, they will not allow you. That much interaction they will have. Listen, we want to make the people who are really working to interact, and at the same time the mission is not complete now. It's a mission just to show, tell you the difficulties of the mission. And where we are, that's what I am briefing. The once the mission is successful, over, and they will speak to you, not me. At that time, I will go behind.
Okay.
At the back. Pearl from the New Indian Express. I had three questions for you, two of which you've already briefly responded to.
Where?
At the back. Here, at the back.
Yeah.
Two of which you've briefly responded to. I'd like you to elaborate on what it means for the Artemis mission, the findings that you're going to have from NASA's payload. One is that, and this whole Chandrayaan 2 mission, how it's going to contribute to Artemis. Two is, you mentioned that moon dust is a major concern for any landing, for any of these moon missions. So if you could elaborate on the moon dust, because I remember reading also in one of your those small notes that you'd given us that moon dust, the lunar dust, is going to be a problem, a hurdle for the mission. Third is, what difference, and this is a very simple one, what difference does it make to have left the Earth in the afternoon than at night? Does it change the position? Because I was told, from what I understood, that we are going to capture the moon from the North Pole, not the South Pole. Is that what it is?
See, the first question that regarding Artemis, and definitely this is this particular mission where we are going to land near South Pole, and Artemis also, that is, they are going to land a man near South Pole. I'm sure that this will give a lot of input to them, but that what input it is going to give, that you don't ask me now, that probably after that the science I can tell you this one. Regarding this, that dust is a concern for everybody, this one, and at the same time, that the single engine, central engine case, the dust usually will go flat outward. It won't come up, this one. That way, the criticality with respect to dust will be less when we are having the central engine. This one. That is the second part. This one. And what is your third question?
Speak to the mic.
What difference does it make to have left Earth in the afternoon than at night as a planner?
No. What happened is this. This is exactly the reason. While madam was asking that even when we are the different launch time. How you are able to achieve the same landing day. This is because what happened is that the landing day is fixed. Because the moon is a fixed, the location of the moon in space is fixed in the landing day. At the same time, that is our launching day now got shifted. Now to go to that same landing day, the same time, so when you are working backward, depending on that every day, what should be the launch time, that we are seeing that in one case, if it is before the 15th that or the before 20th August, we are launching, we'll be able to, we have to launch by early morning. Or if you wanted to come later, I mean, beyond that means that our launch should be the afternoon of this one. That is the way, this one. This depends on the our landing requirement, and to land the requirement, then what the depends on the moon position, earth position, and the time will be decided.
Chandrayaan 1 had an unfortunate early death because of some radiation related issues. What measures were put into Chandrayaan 2 to ensure that
now, whatever it is, really, it is that outcome of the failure analysis committee or that what the recommendations, whatever they mentioned, that we already incorporated in this mission.
Vijay, for you.
How do we differ from this Jade Rabbit of China, Chandrayaan 2?
That is Chinese?
Chinese, they launched and it landed on moon. And Chandrayaan 2, how it differs?
Now that the Chinese, the recent, the not recent, that is the latest one, that they're landing is actually the far side of the moon.
Yeah.
The back side of the moon. Ours is not back side, ours is the front side only.
Okay.
But we are landing just south, near South Pole.
Okay.
Whereas they landed the far side, but near equator. See, near equator landing is very simple.
Okay.
This one. And whereas that, see, like what I'm telling is you assume a globe. Now, about the globe, our orbit is going. And we are going near to the south, the pole. And the pole it can happen only if the orbit is 90 degree. Suppose, whereas if it is coming anywhere landing near there's no such demand, any orbit is okay. Whereas our thing is a unique this one, where we wanted land near South Pole. For that, to meet the requirement, we had essentially the orbit has to be 90 degree only, no other way. If we are not meeting 90 degree, that will miss the target. We'll end up somewhere, suppose the globe is like this, and the orbit is become like this. So it will be away from the landing site. So to land at the place where we want, our inclination of the orbit should be 90 degree. That is a unique constraint, whatever we have, and which nobody else have. And that because of that, maybe because of difficulty only that they would have taken any other thing. Whereas we are looking for the place where nobody else have gone. This one.
This is the first rover being landed on the South Pole?
Near South Pole is the first one. This is the first one. All other things that we see in this, the landing site, it will be near the equator. It is a plus minus 30 or 40 degree from equator. This is only landed.
Yeah, Sandhya.
So Sandhya from the print here. Are you planning to turn on the rover and the lander after 15 days of darkness? Do you expect radiation damage? Or what is the probability that we might be able to turn them back on again?
Radiation.
After the lunar night, will you turn on the lander and rover back on again?
See, after if you are asking me that after these 14 days over, in the lunar night, also the system, if they are able to sustain, is not failed, and once that after 15 days, once again that lunar day starts, we will be able to once again operate the lander and rover.
So will it have, is there a battery backup on board for both the rover and the lander to function when there is no sun?
That is, we have, when the sun, that's what I'm saying, when there's no sun, that the system is, battery is not there, but the battery will be drained out. But at the same time, that the others, the system should not function, they should be healthy. And sometimes in the extreme cold temperature, that may fail. And suppose there's a connection. Suppose connection is lost because of the cold temperature. Then when it is coming there, if nothing got affected, nothing failed in the cold temperature, once that the sun is coming in the lunar day, once again the battery will recharge, and we'll be able to operate the payload.
So what are you expecting right now? Do you expect the payloads to function as before after 15 days, or are you expecting anything to fail in the lunar night?
No, we have qualified the thing at that temperature. At that temperature, we are qualified, but I cannot give confidence to you. It may happen, may not happen, this one.
Yes.
If you are happening, if you are lucky, you will get. That depends on the luck of the horoscope of project director, you have to check.
Sir, this is Swati from Money Control, Network 18. Sir, you had mentioned that the accuracy is very important, that 90 degree inclination. Even if it goes away by 10 centimeter, there will be a difference of 7 degree. So is there a mechanism in place in case there is some difference in the inclination also? Is there a mechanism in place so that there is a leeway which can help you bring back to that degree to reach this 90 degree inclination you have mentioned?
That is, in case that is whatever the error is happening in the our TLI, that can be corrected till it is reaching the moon. Suppose a small deviation, not a very high deviation, a small deviation can be corrected, but that is with the penalty. The correction, suppose the correction may require about 60-70 kg fuel. Then every fuel will be lost.
Right.
That is the thing. See, it is when I'm telling that they are deviating, it is not that it is impossible to correct. If we have infinite sources, we can correct it. But we are working with a limited fuel for doing that one.
Okay.
For any correction, we'll be coming with a penalty of a fuel.
Okay.
Finally, that the fuel may not be available for doing the extra later job. That is the reason.
And what is the small correction you are mentioning? Any, when you say small correction, could you just put a number on that?
See, like for example, like that 10 centimeter extra, suppose there's a deficiency in apogee or the perigee.
Okay.
We have, and we know that this is going to correct, make a 7 degree the inclination correction.
Right.
Suppose after one day, we are trying to correct it. We have to correct around, instead of 10 centimeter per second, we have to do with something like 3 or 4 meter per second.
Oh, okay.
Suppose you are delay further, that will further increase.
Okay. I'm just trying to understand what is the maximum centimeter which you can correct so that the resources can be very effectively utilized for the given, the 14.
No, this is actually nothing, no dispersion. Suppose we have some margin, some 60-70 kg fuel, we have the margin.
Okay.
And within that margins, we are able, we will be able to succeed.
Okay.
Thank you.
Sir,
last two questions.
This is not a science question, but we see that there is craze for making science fiction movies these days. So has anybody approached you to make a movie on Chandrayaan 2, the fascinating journey of Chandrayaan? Or will ISRO hold the copyrights so that the facts are not distorted, and even if a movie is made, will you?
No, we have not got any request till now. Probably after 7th we may get after landing.
Last question.
Yes, sir.
But sir, we have the copyrights with you.
Sir, as far as human colony on moon or an outpost on moon, how important is this Chandrayaan 2 mission? And the second thing, ISRO is promoting Yuva Vaigyanik Karyakram, and you are interacting with a lot of students. So how this mission is going to ignite the young minds?
See, that is, we have had that our Yuva Vaigyanik, the Karyakram, that activity we initiated, and really, the people who are excited more about the Chandrayaan 2 mission is basically that our young students. The type of the letters or communication I'm getting, that what is the type of thing, is something fantastic. And really that it is excited that youngster's mind.
Okay, last question, Srikant, last question, please.
No.
Please.
Now you ask, allow him to ask us.
Last question. Please. Let him speak to Mike. Mike, please.
Huh?
How this mission is important for the human colony or an outpost?
See, that's what I'm telling. This is going to, it is the place where we are expecting that a lot of resources are going to be there. And this, sir, the mission is going to give an input about the resources really at the near South Pole. It will be having a major input data for the future colonization. We are future colonization again with their plan in near South Pole only.
Yes, sir. Last question.
That way, this is going to give that major input data for that.
Yeah, last.
Sir, I hope we will be part of those 15 terrifying moments rather than being briefed like this after the landing.
Sure, sir.
I said on September 6th, 7th, I hope we will be part of those 15 terrifying moments,
yes,
rather than being briefed after the landing.
Yes. You will be definitely part of that.
Thank you.
You will be part of the terrifying moment. That's what we are planning.
Thank you.
It is just like whatever we used to do for Sriharikota, the similar arrangement we are going to make it.
Sriharikota, you didn't brief us, sir.
What after Chandrayaan 2?
Okay.
After Chandrayaan 2, sir, have you started looking beyond Chandrayaan 2? On moon, related to moon?